So we have a massive Black Friday sale. In terms of like, dude, we never thought we were ever gonna do this. We never thought we'd let it do a free trial basis. But then we decided to do it. Alex says, let's do it. And the reason we're doing this is because of this. Too many people do not know the difference between MIC and anybody else. They automatically assume that every service is the same. They assume that everybody's just pumping and dumping. No one's teaching, no one's educating. And so there's two types of people. There's ones that are just chasing the cheapest room out there. Oh, do you have a Black Friday sale? How much percent off? Is it 90% off? I'll join if it's $1 a day. I mean, okay. I mean, would you go and live in an apartment if it was $1 a day? You can live in the streets for free. Would you go and, do whatever? I mean, would you eat this fucking leftover sandwich I gave you? It's 25 cents. So you get what you pay for, guys. It's like education, right? It's like you want to learn how to make doctor wages. Or are you going to be learning from some guy on the street that's injecting people with tire silicone to make their booty bigger to be your doctor? You know? Or are you going to go to Harvard or Stanford and learn how to become a medical professional? You're trying to become a day trader to make as much as a doctor or even more than a doctor. Alex made 50 something thousand today in the first hour, guys. That's more than any fucking doctor I know. Unless he's injecting people with all sorts of shit, right? But so you're expecting to make doctor wages, lawyer wages, politician wages, but you don't expect to put in any work. And so that's the problem. A lot of the problem is these other services. They, to be honest, dude, most people can't trade worth shit. So they fucking start teaching. They are new traders that find a little success. So there's these guys that's like, oh, I'm up. I grew my account from 7,000 to $500,000 this year. I'm ready to teach. Well, no, you're not, motherfucker. You just got lucky. And good for you if you did that. But the point is, there's a difference between trading for yourself, guys, and trading to educate others so that they too can do what you do. And just because you can do it doesn't mean they can do it too. You know, some of these guys are massively revenge trading. Up, down, $100,000 within a day. They're bragging about that shit. Well, guess what, dude? Most people don't even have $10,000 in their fucking account. And you're teaching a strategy where you have to fucking double down. And, you know, if you're a normal person, you're down $2,000. That's a lot of money. That's your rent money, right? You don't have the emotional stability to handle that. Your girlfriend's kick your butt, your wife's gonna kick your butt, whoever's gonna kick your butt. You can't pay the rent. You know, so you can't just like, okay, take a $2,000 loss and then be okay about it. And then let's keep on trading. And that's what we call revenge trading. Okay, and we're opening up the room to show you how the real traders trade. I'm not joking. Every trader has risk management. If your guru is not managing their risk, they are not a real trader. They trade for themselves, that's fine. They will never be hired in a professional Wall Street environment. Every Wall Street environment has a risk compliance manager. They shut you down when things are going bad. If you take a look at Alex, you know, his big days way more than his down days. So if you take a look at these other guys, they're swinging up and down. They're bragging they're down $500,000 and then they make it back and then shit like that. It's like, I mean, do you really want to trade like that? It may work for them. I'm not bashing them. What I'm bashing is this, guys. I'm bashing the education that they're giving to people. Okay? So when you think I'm bashing these guys on Twitter, I'm not bashing them. They have an education service. Okay? I'm bashing the way they're fucking going to teach you, because you are not going to become a successful trader. Very few people is able to revenge trade successfully. And so we are opening the room. Well, all you guys, right? There's 180 people right now watching this stream. Did you take advantage of this Black Friday? We only have a few slots left, guys. We're opening the room for 3 free days for you. 3 days. This is your opportunity to come in. If you take a look at the watch list, Alex woke up today. Jeez, what time did you wake up, Alex? I was up at 3:30. He was up at way before that. He already got a watch list ready for the room. And he planned it. The reason Alex made $50 something thousand today, because he planned it. It wasn't by accident. It wasn't by coming 5 minutes into the market, slamming giant ass orders, and scalping giant ass orders, revenge trading, and then bragging about it to members. That's not how you fucking trade, guys. The key is planning. We keep talking about planning. The planning includes what? Predefining your risk. These idiots do not have any sort of risk. They're like, oh, I'm willing to risk $500,000 to make $6,000. I'm not joking. This is what fucking the conversation is going on. And I'm telling you, I'm not bashing them. I'm bashing the fact that they're teaching people. And this is not how you should learn. So we decided to open up MIC to show you exactly the MIC process and how we trade. Alice and I have made fucking a fortune. I made more money in one day than those guys make. They only wish they can make that shit. And I don't even need to brag about it. And when I made it, you never see me swing like that. Knock on wood. I don't want to ever be like down 100,000, up 100,000 in a day. We have a max. We have risk profiles. We have max loss rules. They call it training wheels. I'm like, fuck, I don't give a fuck. My training wheel is made out of fucking diamond. Gold fucking rims, you know? I don't give a fuck you call what the fuck it is. You know, none of those guys will ever touch Alex and I in the way we do it. Alex works an hour a day. He never swings up and down 100,000. The goal of a day trader, guys, is not to fucking brag about how much you fucking came from the abyss, about how you were a fucking loser, should have fucking took the loss, but you didn't take the loss, so you held on and you made your money back. The job of a day trader, guys, I'm telling you right now, dude, there's two types of people when they day trade. They day trade to show off. They post this shit because they want to let you know how rich they are, how big balls they are. I'm not, you know, that's not the way you do it. The real guys, the real money, you don't even know they have money. They don't want stress. This is a job. When I started trading, I wanted action. When I was a beginner, guys, I wanted action. I was so fucking bored because I made consistent $3,000, $4,000 every fucking day. But I didn't realize that's $1 million a year without doing any effort because I was so bored. So what I do is I like to fucking dip my toe in the water, have an action. You know, it's so exciting. It's so exciting. I was up and down. But you know, as I got older and more mature, I call this trader maturity, guys. It's not about how much you make in a day. It's how much you make it with the least amount of risk, with the least amount of stress, in the least amount of time possible. Because at this level, man, there's really no difference between making a few thousand dollars more. It's not going to change my life. It's not going to change Alex's life. But if we do it with no risk, and we can continue on the rest of our day, like we're done. Alex is done. 1 hour a day, low risk. There's a famous quote, guys, that I coined. Remember this quote? You only need to get rich once. I'm going to say it again. You only need to get rich once. Means this. When you have it, lock it the fuck up. One of these days, those guys will lose all their fucking money. I've heard stories all the time. Oh man, I was up $1 million and then I lost it and then made it back. I lost it. I'm like, oh, you fucking idiot. I don't want to be the comeback kid. I want to be the kid that never fucking lost it back. I don't want to be the fifth. Like, oh, this is the fifth time I won my heavyweight title back. I don't want to fucking ever lose my title, my heavyweight title. I want to get that title and retire in the Hall of Fame without a fucking single loss. You know, if it's grimy, so be it. I don't give a fuck. It doesn't have to be flashy, but I am going to win. At the end of the day, I'm going to fucking win. You know, it's so tonight after this, think about to yourself. Seriously, guys, are you trading because you want to make money, or are you trading because it's fucking cool? You want to be the cool kid? Or are you treating as a business? If you treat this as a business, would you be doing and risking what you're risking? Ask yourself that, to be honest. Would you do this in your day job? It's like, oh, in your day job. Let's say you have a fucking 9 a.m. meeting. And it's with a client. And the client's going to give you a hell of money, potentially. Would you fucking show up 5 minutes before, unprepared? Or would you be prepared, come there super early, and be prepared and take no risk? You just want to lock the deal up. Treat trading as a business, guys, and it will go far. Stop fucking following these fucking guys that have no control. They make money for themselves. Good job. I'm happy for them. The point is, this is not bashing anybody. It's bashing the education that's out there. So all you guys are watching this right now, guys, we opened it for the 3-day trial, okay? Go to myinvestmentclub.com/Black Friday. There should be all of you guys checking this out. Because you're watching this right now, why not come and check it out? You'll see. We want to teach you to become a self-sufficient trader. We don't post, we don't pump. What we do is we give you a watch list. That is pretty much our alert. But the alert is actually a guideline. It's a trading guideline. And we trade right off that. Last night, Alex posted a video for all the MIC to watch on how to trade these sector plays, how to look for the head of the snake, how to know when it's time to short. Because these sector plays, they're driven by what we call the head of a snake, the mother, okay, who spawns out all the sympathy plays. When the mother play dies, which is the main play, because what happens is this, the main play gets pumped up and people miss the main play because it's $75 a share. The original main play was Tesla, dude. It's too expensive, Tesla. So then the EV sector had BLNK, then it had XPEV, things like that. And then all these other stocks, right, that came as cheaper. So if you miss any of those, you go for the cheaper one. And so we call those sympathy plays. And the easiest trades are usually the ones just shorting off the sympathy plays. But it's fine. You can short whatever you want, but the key is to understand this process. And one of our moderators, Aloha Trader Austin, he said something. If you did not trade today, you did not even wake up, you did 90% better than most day traders today. Because 90% of the day traders, you're probably gonna fucking lose. I hear so many people blowing up on EV stocks. You know, I hear people down 100,000, up 100,000, down something like that. So if you had just woken up and did nothing, you'd be better off than them. Okay? And I call it the hero. Heroes are great. But heroes die. Most heroes in movies die. Every single Asian, Korean drama, the hero dies. Every Chinese film, the hero dies. That's what it is. I don't want to be a fucking hero. I want to be the fucking guy at the end that's with the fucking girl with all the money. Because I'm the friend of the hero. I'm the fucking best friend of the hero. The hero comes in, he saves the day, he dies. Well, I'm going to clean up the... just remember that Snapple commercial? I don't want to be number one. I just want to be number three. You know, that's what it is. So you keep it safe because, you know, at the end of the day, dude, I don't really need to be the hero. You know, you want to be a hero, it's okay. So what I want to do is this, okay? So we have that. And then one more thing, guys. We're having on my Twitter, I'm going to retweet again. Just for fun, I saw someone do this. And then I was like, okay. So we're giving away $500, $100 to five people if they just start following us and tag their friends. Because we want to grow organically through friends of friends. And so that's why I just did that as an experiment. So you follow the thing, you have your friend follow us on Instagram and follow us on YouTube. And then, so the winner is gonna be announced tomorrow at 2 p.m. market time during Tosh's webinar. So we have a schedule at MIC. Monday, Alex does the Instagram live, the YouTube live. Tuesday, I do this, the IG live. Tuesday at night, Joe Kelly does the large cap webinar for members. So there's a large cap webinar tonight, guys. So join as a free trial and you'll see the webinar tomorrow. Actually tonight too, I think Alex is doing a webinar for the new people too. So we have basically webinars every day, guys. And this is, you know, this is the education we provide you. It's not just pumping it up during the market, right? So tomorrow during Tosh's webinar, Tosh, you can type more information and I'll tweet it out as well. So follow that. We're gonna pick five people at random to win $100 each for fun. Why not, right? But definitely join the free trial because this won't happen again, guys, anytime soon. We decide just, we got pissed off and we said, hey man, I see all these Black Friday sales. Everybody's trying to like give 80% off their shit because their shit is really shit. That's why we don't want to discount it 80% because our stuff is really good, guys. Other fucking, hey, we're open for other fucking gurus too. I know there's gurus in our chat room learning all our process because they're using the same term that they're not using, so we won't mention it. But hey, we are agnostic. We will teach anybody because, you know why, this is not a competition. Seriously, I just want people to fucking learn a trade correctly. And if you create a valuable service, people will come. This is not us trying to do gimmicks to get fucking money. I hate that gimmick game. I hate the slashing 80% off bullshit game, right? So I just give 3 days free trial. So what I'm gonna do is this. I'm gonna bring Alex on real quick. Hey, Alex, raise your hand. And then Alex will talk about his trade today.
Yo.
Yo.
How's the beard look? Too much?
Dude, I'm growing mine out for the no shave. In November or some shit.
Bro, the barbers aren't taking me, bro, because of COVID. So I either have to do it myself or just let it grow. So I don't know what I'm going to do.
Hey, man, you can, like, keep growing it until you lose. That's what I did before. And I don't know if you can survive 3 months, bro.
I don't know, bro. Let's see. I was going to also talk about something. You mentioned that I posted the videos yesterday. So for those that see, yesterday at 7:20, I posted two videos, how to trade sector plays, and first red day on sympathy plays. And if you just watched those two videos that I posted today, you would have nailed every single trade that came our way.
So quickly tell them, like, what was your process today without giving the secret sauce? Because join and you'll see this video, guys. It's a no-brainer.
Literally, you join with the Black Friday trial and you get to see those videos as well. But basically, yeah, so this is what happened, right? So historically, every November, we get some crazy runners. You know, we had the shipper stocks, we had the coronavirus stocks, we had the Bitcoin stocks, and, you know, it just so happened this year it was the electric vehicle stocks because of Tesla. And, you know, a lot of these stocks caught a lot of people off guard because shorts have had it pretty easy lately. Like lately, stocks go up and they come right back down. And a lot of new traders that are entering the market for the first time this year don't really know what it's like to be trading a sector play. These stocks literally go from 5 to 20 or 2 to 50, or like XPEV went to $75. Like, these stocks are crazy, right? And a lot of people, they just short and short and short because in the past, revenge trading and adding to a loser paid out for them. And all those amateur guys that had no process, that were not an MIC, that didn't know what they were doing, they probably blew up during the sector play. They blew up before it all came back, right? And the problem is that people are lacking education. They don't know what they don't know, right? So a lot of people today killed it. It was a really good day, but this is what happened. So the way it works is there's usually a head of the snake that we talk about, right? And the head of the snake this time was XPEV. So basically all we waited to do was we waited for XPEV to go red and tank, right? When that happened, all these other sympathy plays like FCEL, DPW, BLNK, Solo, all the bids just disappeared, right? They all just disappeared. And now, if you kind of look at the chart of XPEV, fucker went back green during zombie times. Right? Oh. At 10:30, it went back green.
So, wait, higher? What price is that now?
It's at 73.85.
Woo. So once again, another rule, Alex. What time did it start bouncing?
10:30 on the dot. So a lot of people, they laughed at us when we talked about the zombie rule when we first started. They said, these guys don't know what they're talking about. They're a joke, this and that. Now you see people with the undead hours. You see people with the 10 a.m. rule. You see people with the 10:15 rule. So, I mean, these rules that we kind of created at MIC, obviously they sound obscure so that we know who's copying us. But the truth of the matter is the only way that we learn these rules is by losing, right? On a day like today, Bao and I would have made money. We would have said, shit, there's so much more money. There's so much more money. Let's go short. Let's go short. Let's
green,
go short.
Green, because we're up. We were, you know, you're up. You have cushion.
Exactly. We start playing the cushion game with ourselves. And then what happens? XPEV bounces back green. Blink bounces back to 30. Wow. FCEL bounces back to $9. And you would have been dead. You would have lost all your money. So after doing this for hundreds of times probably, we finally created a process around it for ourselves. And that rule, that one rule that took us years and six figures worth of losses to learn is my number one rule right now. So I'm up 57, 58,000. I'm done for the day. Even though these look really exciting to short again, I know that my process tells me I'm probably going to lose money with it, right? So today was a day where we waited for the head of the snake to tank. We shorted the sympathy plays, usually when they went red or when they broke their trend. And here we are, you know, 11:30 in the morning, just basically done for the day. If I want right now, I'm going to go to the gym. I'm going to help the members out. I'm going to maybe get a steak for myself. But this is the freedom that trading allows us to get.
Guys, I'm actually doing the stairs because the gym is closed. I'm just walking up and down the stairs.
Exactly. So think about it. Bao is, what time is there? Probably like 8 o'clock or 7 o'clock in the morning right there. and he's done with his day before people are even waking up to work. And this is why trading is so important, guys. It is not meant to be this full-time 8-hour-a-day thing. It is there to supplement your income and trade for 1 hour a day. People see
like we said, man, being a full-time trader does not mean you trade all the time.
Yeah, man. That's,
you don't need to. If you sit around, this is how people lose. I'm telling you right now. Okay, take a look at my Twitter. Today I gave a little hint on how we're going to trade these sector plays. I said the EV market is not going to die. It won't die because people are holding this. Moms and dads, they are not day trading this shit. They miss Tesla. They do not want to miss this shit.
Yep.
It will die when it dies. Yep. You know, that's the thing.
Today was the easiest trades today because now the momentum has shifted. Now that doesn't mean that these stocks are going to tank forever, but the easy money on these sector plays is now over. I'm not going to be messing around with this shit. I don't want to screw around because now what's going to happen is the volume is going to shrink and the algos are going to come take over it again if they really want to. I'm going to be focused elsewhere, like stocks like SPI and OPTT. If you look at SPI and OPTT, these are non-electric vehicle companies, and they were the easiest ones to fade today because everyone else was focused on the electric vehicle companies. So while all the amateur people continue to focus on the electric vehicle companies, tomorrow, Bao and I are going to be looking for the other stocks that people don't really care about. And this is our process, guys. This is what we focus on. This is what we do every single day. And this is what members are able to replicate. Today, James is one of our moderators, right? So James joined MIC on day one. After 6 months of being in MIC, we promoted him to a moderator. After a year and a half of being in MIC, he bought his dream car, which was an i8. And today he had his biggest career day ever at $14,000 in one day. Woo! And he's not going to brag about it. He only told me about it, but I just want to kind of get him excited because this is something, he is a homegrown MIC success story, right? And the last sector play that we had was coronavirus. We were on the phone for literally 12 hours during the coronavirus crash. And that gave him the practice to be able to attack the next sector play, which was the electric vehicle companies, guys. And this is the type of mentorship that we give at MIC. This is why I think that you guys should compare us to anyone else, because you don't know what you're missing out on, right?
Show him the tweet. He says, this is the key. He kept his losses small until now.
Let me see.
So show that. This is what we
teach. Yesterday, James lost $300, right? He lost a day's worth of work to be able to today make fucking so much more than that. And that's what it's all about.
So the key, once again, is risk management. Keep your losses small, guys. You know, live to fight another day. When the opportunity is there, you strike.
Yep, and that's how it is. And we do this every single day, right? So, I mean, like, there's no better opportunity than right now to literally just check us out and see what we're all about. You know, if you think we're full of shit, check us out and see. If you are unhappy somewhere else, check us out. If you're losing money, check us out. You have literally no reason not to take advantage of this free trial, guys.
Only arrogance, that's the reason.
I mean, arrogance is what's going to lead to them blowing up their accounts, right? I mean, it's not a problem to us. The more uneducated money there is, the more money we make from trading, right? That's just how it works. It is smart money taking the money out of the pockets of dumb money. So today, on the first red day setup, there was probably a lot of inexperienced longs that got stuck, that bought the dip, that got trapped. Meanwhile, we were the ones shorting it because we have a process. We have a strategy that is repeatable, that works. And you know what, man? Today, as good as $50,000 or $58,000 sounds, I mean, honestly, it's just I'm so desensitized to it that it doesn't really matter. Tomorrow's just a new day. My plan is
– Hey, Alex, you know what is? I'm going to tell you what happened when you made that. When you made that, you're like, why didn't I make 100 grand?
You're like, I did fuck up. I did fuck up today.
So that's the problem, guys. You will never be happy. Never. You know, that day I made $1.5 million, I was like, motherfucker, I was up $2
million. Yeah.
You know, you will never be happy. You know? And so the thing is, it gets to the point where you become desensitized like Alex. And that's the best shit. Because after a while, guys, this is why action kills people. When you do something for a long time, it gets really boring. And trading, to be honest, should be boring because it's a business. Yeah. You think Amazon CEO is having fun every day? He's fucking bored. Yep. He has trillions of dollars, right? So he's looking for other shit. So what he's doing now is educating people. He's giving money away. He's basically saying, I want to save the earth and give his money away. So same thing with MIC, guys. People think we do this shit for money. Dude, they'd be surprised how much you fucking make.
Literally nothing.
So the whole point of this, guys, okay, I'm going to end it really quickly. You guys are some smart people. Me and Alex have been walking around doing YouTube lives, doing meetups since we started.
For 2 years, bro. For 2 years, we've been doing it every single week.
Consistency. Yep. And you know why we do this? Who the fuck takes time off of their training to help you guys? How many hours was I fucking in the chat room last night? I was literally in there for like fucking 16 fucking hours.
Once people, it's crazy because people join from other communities and they say, hey man, I'm part of the XYZ. I have a question for you. Why don't you just ask the guy that you're paying? Instead, they come to us, right? So the access that you get by being an MIC is second to none, right? You have access to me, Bao, our moderators, mentors, videos, everything. So again, just try us out, man. And there's literally no reason why you shouldn't. And I don't know why thousands of people aren't even trying.
Hey, Alex, show me your DMs. Just scroll through all the fucking DMs.
Oh, my God, bro.
I'm telling you, no one fucking does this. What million-dollar trader is going to fucking answer your PMs?
Right now, before I started, I closed it all out. And right now, I already have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. About five.
No, just scroll through all the old ones. They still list the old ones.
Yeah, give me a second.
So my whole point is, like, we answer these PMs. There's nobody answering this shit. Oh, look at that.
Doesn't end, bro.
Yeah, so, I mean, that says it all, guys. So the bottom line is this. This is very simple, guys. We're going to sum it down to this. If you really want to learn to trade for yourself and make something out of your life long-term, join MIC. If you're here to gamble, do not join MIC. Simple as that. Go to casino. Go bet on the fucking Patriots or whatever the hell you want to bet on. It's much easier to go to the casino play blackjack than it is to get rich quick. Because most of the time, you know, people lose. And so that's the honest truth. And so we really don't need the people that's going to come in that want to get rich quick. And so it's okay. Go to the other places. You know, there's places for everybody. There's people that educate on you how to get rich quick and to lose quick. Yep. So anything else, Alex? Tomorrow, tell them about the webinar real quick.
Oh, yeah. So let me actually mention two things. Number one is tonight we are doing a webinar for all of our members, right? So if you join with a free trial today, you are going to have access to a webinar. It's going to be a group webinar with me, Tosh, and Faye. We're going to be recapping today's trades, and we're going to be taking Q&A, like questions from the audience.
Tell quickly who Faye is.
So Faye, if you guys don't know who Faye is, that's crazy. But number one is Faye is a member that joined, and after I think it was about 30 days or 45 days, she found consistency. After her second week of MIC, she joined annual. After the third week, I think she joined lifetime, and now she is a moderator making probably more money than me and Bao.
Yeah. I don't want to say some shit, but she pulled out $22,000 last week.
Yeah, sick.
I mean, this is someone that just started trading this year, just a few months ago, you know?
I think, what was it, February 1st or January 1st, something like that.
Yeah, and you know what the difference is? She came in. This is a huge advantage. So the people says, I don't want to join because I don't know anything yet. Let me learn on my own first and join. That's the wrong approach. The best time to learn and join is when you know nothing. You have zero bad habits. You learn the MIC process from day one. And that's what James did. That's what Faye did. Faye didn't know how to trade. She learned the MIC process. So she didn't know any bad habits. Yep. She started using hard stops from day one.
Yep.
So, I mean, that's the thing. Imagine you've never used a hard stop. It's going to be very hard to switch into using a hard stop, but you have to start using that.
Yep. Exactly, guys. I mean, the point is you can look at mine and Bao's success, and that's great, but what we pride ourselves on is the success of our members, right? So if you see another community of a guy making tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands, you should probably see if anyone else is able to do that. The answer 90% of the time is no. That only works for them. So what we pride ourselves on is our process is repeatable, and our members are actually consistently making money. So it's up to you guys if you want to try it out.
A couple of things. I have two more things. So we know it's repeatable because, you know what, when we post our charts, other members are posting the same entries and exits as us. The charts are pretty much identical because we're using the same strategies and process that we're teaching. And this strategy works long, shorts, large caps, small caps. James last week, I interviewed James last week, JJ, he was under PDT 7,000, I think grew to 90,000 bucks in 6 months. It's all about the process, guys. You're not going to get there on the first day or the third day, but keep at it. It's a long, anything in life, man, is worth it. It's going to put some time into it. But I guarantee you, it won't take you as long as going to college, okay? You can learn this much quicker than college and much cheaper too, so. All right, guys, yep. So we'll see you tomorrow. Webinar, Tosh, tonight, webinar at 7 p.m.
Market yep, 5. Webinar at 7 p.m. inside MIC. The link will be posted 10 minutes before.
Black Friday, we have a few slots left. Guys, I'm telling you right now, this is your chance. We'll see you.